As a software developer, you have encountered the term blockchain popping up in job posts, tech articles, and research. Maybe colleagues mention blockchain in conversations about cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin, ETH, and Dogecoin. But what precisely is a blockchain, and how is it used? In this video, as part of a developer blockchain explainer series, I'll walk you through a brief overview of what a blockchain is. So let's dive right in. A blockchain runs on a network of computers worldwide. Each system hosts blockchain software that stores data and transactions in an immutable shared ledger. We say it's immutable, but technically it is just extremely challenging to change the recorded historical data of the blockchain. If you've never heard of a ledger before, they were traditionally paper documents, which contained the details of every financial transaction. These days, companies store their data in documents, including their ledgers, in databases. So at its core, a blockchain can really be thought of as an immutable shared ledger database. You can run one of these computers in a blockchain network by downloading special open source software called a blockchain client. There are also specialized computers made just for hosting blockchains. Any computer running the client software is called a node on the blockchain network. Because anyone can run a node, we say blockchains are decentralized, meaning no single entity can control the entire blockchain. Decentralization is a crucial reason blockchains are so revolutionary. Blockchains are the technology that powers decentralized digital currencies, known as cryptocurrencies. In fact, blockchains are popularized because of one specific cryptocurrency, Bitcoin. We call the blockchain that powers Bitcoin the Bitcoin blockchain, while the cryptocurrency itself is just called Bitcoin. Thus, the computers in the Bitcoin blockchain store transactions that capture the transfer value in Bitcoin. Both the concept of blockchains and Bitcoin were introduced to the world in the Bitcoin white paper, which was distributed online anonymously by the mysterious entity known as Satoshi Nakamoto. You can find a link to the white paper in the description below. However, blockchains don't just support cryptocurrency. Blockchains can also serve as platforms that store code known as smart contracts. Clients for smart contract blockchains contain virtual machines that allow them to interpret and run the code. Thus, some blockchains are decentralized application platforms that leverage virtual machines. Ethereum, the most popular smart contract blockchain, was the first to store and run smart contracts. Smart contracts enable developers to create applications that are open to anyone, historically transparent, and egalitarian compared to today's typical web applications. Smart contracts are creating a new paradigm of the web itself, sometimes dubbed Web 3.0. Throughout this video, I've been talking about public blockchains, which are typically open to anyone. There are also consortium blockchains that companies and organizations run. But typically, when people discuss blockchains, they are referring to public blockchains. In summary, a blockchain can be thought of as a decentralized database storing immutable data ranging from financial transactions to smart contract code. Nodes are computers that run blockchains, and anyone can run a node. The Bitcoin blockchain is an example of a blockchain that focuses on value transfer, and Ethereum is an example of a blockchain that focuses on smart contracts. Blockchains are a fascinating, innovative technology, revolutionizing the internet, and we'll continue talking about why they're so revolutionary throughout this series. I'll hash you in the next block.